valley, standing with my hands held high. The valley will never take my song. Find me in the desert, holding on to you for life. The desert will never take my song. Oh, the desert will never take my song. I will praise you. I will praise you. Dancing where you prophesied, still shouting of everything you've done. High up on the mountain, I was made to testify. Forever, you will have my song. Oh, forever.
Goeiemôre gemeente. Ja, dit sal weer Sondag. Die week het gevlieg. Maar dit is goeie ding. Laat die week vlieg. Laat ons uit hierdie omstandighede uit kan kom. Ek dink, kom ons vra die Here dat hierdie dae so vinnig verby moet gaan. Laat 2020 iets van die verlede raak. Hierdie omstandighede waaronder is, vir iets van die verlede raak. Dat ons kan weer kyk of ons normaal kan bereik. Maar alles op einde, kom ons begin hierdie diens en hierdie boodskap in die naam van God die Vader en die Seun en die Heilige Gees. Amen. Die mannes, ons thema vir die maand is vir my baie in die voorhand is to celebrate God's workmanship. En ek like die celebrate en ek probeer vandag ons dominee het ons ingelei en vir ons gevat na 'n punt toe wat ons verstaan hoekom en waarom ons God se vakmanskap en creativity en al die kan celebrate. Ek vat dit verder en ek lees vir ons 'n versie wat opgeteken is in Efesiëns. Nou, to celebrate and to and talk about God's workmanship. Die Afrikaanse sê dit bietjie anders, maar ek wil my bietjie beter uitdruk in 'n Engels, en dis hoekom ek dit bietjie voorberei het ook so. Kom ons lees die vers, Efesiëns 2 vers 10. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God has prepared beforehand what we should walk, that we should walk in them. This verse bring out everything that God wants. And I want to start about celebrate the workmanship of the potter of God. We are his workmanship. So, if you want to celebrate, you have to know what and how and what is the reason for the celebration. And how can we satisfy and please during this celebration? Because celebrations has always have to bring a satisfaction, have a satisfactory outcome. So we are His workmanship. You are, I am, a piece of work by the Creator. You are a masterpiece. You are His image come into existence. God image comes into existence. That's what we are, because He created us into His likeness, into His image. You are God's imaging, becoming flesh and spirit. And the Hebrew word for this is biomia, biomia. And it's just, that word just mean God's image, God's imaging. And we, as Christians, we as believers, we as His creation, have to come into His likeness. How can we do that? So, when God created human beings, He loved them so much. He created them. This is His masterpiece, is His best work. All of the other works, He said, like Dominic said yesterday, last Sunday, He said, He spoke a word and it appeared and it came to existence. Just the word of God bring it to existence. But when it comes to human beings, when it comes to you and me, God goes, sit down and He planned and He said, let's create somebody in our own likeness. And God take out of the dust of the earth, form with His hands something. That's why we are His workmanship, His handcraft, His masterpiece. I read Ephesians 1 verse 18, quickly, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of His calling? What are the riches of His glory and His inheritance in the saints? And what is the exceeding greatness of His power towards us who believe according to the work of His mighty power? That's what God put into us. That's what God created into us. That's what God already had built into His workmanship, all the powers. The only thing is our eyes must be enlightened. Our eyes must be come open so that we can see God's workmanship. Way back we had the song that we sing in the Ikayafia that say, I see Jesus in you. I feel Jesus in your touch. I hear Jesus in your voice, and that makes me love you. So, we are created not for ourselves. Let me quickly read this one for you. It is Ephesians 2 verse 8. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourself, but it is a gift of God, not for works, lest anyone should boast. For we are His workmanship, created in Christ. Just before the verse, just before that one, before then, 8 and 9 say, we are saved by grace, and God saved us for this purpose. We are His workmanship. And because sin comes and separates us from God, God make a plan to bring us back to Him. His crafting, His handwork. He cannot let us go by that. He created us. He don't want to let us go. So, how do we do it? He sent Jesus. Jesus came, He died for us, He paid for our sin, He brought us back to life again and back to God again. The only way to the Father is through Jesus Christ. So, Jesus come and modeled the way. He walked on this earth and He shows us this is how we celebrate the workmanship, the craftsmanship. We celebrate God, our Father. This is how we please God. And Jesus came and He do it this way. God is love. Jesus came down and showed us God's love. Jesus came and He do a lot of good works. He do a lot of good deeds. His love, the love of the Father was shining through Him. The love of the Father, everything that the Father wants, the calling of the Father was shining through Him, through Jesus. We cannot do it on our own. If you don't have Jesus, you cannot celebrate God's workmanship. You cannot be His masterpiece. You cannot betray what God wants you to be, the purpose that He created us for. Ephesians 3, verse 17 to 19. That Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, that you, being rooted and grounded in love, may be able to comprehend what all the saints, that is the worth and the height, length and the depth and the height of, to know the love of Christ which passes all knowledge, that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. Only through Christ. Only through Christ we can be filled with the God's love. And we sing it in the church Sunday after Sunday. God's liefde is so groot, God is so machtig, daar's niks wat my God nie kan doen. Nou, God is in ons deur Jesus Christus. In die krag en die power, die Heilige Gees se werking en God se grootheid en Jesus se alles wat Christus was, is alreeds binne in ons. We are created in His image, in His likeness, and we have the same mindset that was in Jesus Christ. And because of that, we are who we are, His masterpiece. But why are we celebrating it? Why are we God's masterpiece? And it says that in Christ Jesus, we are for what? For good works. Ephesians 2:10. For good works. I mean, I was good in photography. I did photography for more than 25 years. And I got some money out of it. And I think, wow, this is a good plan. This is the way I go. I have to go. And when I have the opportunity to buy a shop and started my own photography shop, I went to my mentor and the mentor said, Gerhard, it's not for you. Everything was on the table. I am a photographer. I can take good photos. So I have a good camera. Everything was ready. Everything business was there. I worked in a Photoshop for more than 5 years. It was there. My plan was laid out. I can make means out of it. But that's my plan. And then God says, my mentor says, Gerhard, you are crafted and you are called by God for mission, for teaching, not for photography, not for business, not for having your own thing going. Well, it really took the wind out of my sails. And I went down on my knees and I said, God, now, what did you plan for me? What good works had you for me? I have to realize, I have to come to God's plan, God's way of doing it, God's work for me, God's call for me to do His prepared work. Things that is in God's will for my life. God's desire for me. I am His workmanship. I am His craft. I am His masterpiece. He created me for something. He wants to see what comes out of His hand works, His craft. And I have to come to His plan, what He prepared for me, His will, His work. And now, after 15 years, nearly, I'm here. I'm better off. I don't miss it. I still have my camera. I can still take photos, but I don't have a Photoshop. It's fine. I do what God wants me to do, and I'm fulfilled. I'm pleased. I'm satisfied. I have joy in what I'm doing. I'm walking in what God prepared for me in Christ Jesus. I cry that you, in the last line in this whole verse 10, it says that we should walk in them. What? That's what God planned for us. We should walk into that. And I look at Jesus' life and I say, Jesus walked in love. Jesus walked in faith. Jesus walked in obedience. Jesus walked in holiness. Too many end of last year, last week, with that we have to, the 4 of them, walk in love. Walk in obedience, walk in faith, walk in holiness. And I add mine for this week, walk with Jesus. You cannot do it if you don't have Christ. So my brother, my sister, do you have Christ in your life? To celebrate God's crafting, you have to have Jesus. Only with Jesus we will please the potter. Only with Jesus we will satisfy the Father. Only with Jesus we are able and capable of putting the joy on God's face. If we don't have Jesus, if we don't have Jesus, the Father cannot even celebrate. How can we celebrate? Do you have joy in what you're doing? Do you have fulfillment in what you are doing? If you have not, then I think you don't have Jesus. 2 Corinthians 5 verse 17 says, 2 Corinthians 5 verse 17, I'm quickly turning to that. Verse 17, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. All things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Who you are for till now, after Christ in your life, it must be new. It cannot be the same. This year, 2020, will not be repeated next year, because next year is 2021. 2019 was a great year. It's not repeated in 2020. 2020 is different. Every time when you are in Christ and you renew your relationship with Christ, to celebrate, it's a new thing. Every celebration becomes a new thing. Please, don't lose focus of the cross. Keep your eyes on the cross. Keep walking with Jesus. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for your word. Thank you for this word that is so profound. Thank you for this word that is so new. Thank you for this word that is so enlightening. Yes, Lord, we were seeking and we were longing and we want to come together. But we keep on extending the lockdown, and the lockdown keep us away from each other. My prayer is that this lockdown draw us closer in our inner man, closer to you in our Bible study at home, closer to you. I know that you will never leave or forsake us. That's why we celebrate what you create. Help us, Jesus. Holy Spirit, thank you for being still. Thank you for staying behind to lead us in this truth and to guide us. We glorify you. We give you all the honor. In Jesus' name. Amen. So, dear mothers, daar waar jy is, ek wil 'n tydjie vat. As jy dit nog nie gedoen het nie, en graag wil doen, bel my, laat ons met mekaar praat, sodat jy nader na die Here toe kom. Of, as jy die Here wil aanneem, kan ek na jou toe kom, en ek lei jou na Christus toe. Moenie bang wees nie. Jy het alles al probeer. Kom, ek challenge jou. Probeer Jesus. Gee Jesus 'n kans. Gee Jesus 'n kans. En dan kyk ons wat gebeur. As dit nie werk nie, by all means, then you can go your own way again.